So as we have learnt a lot about arrays, so a little bit of recapitulation of the array thing. See, we used to declare an array int an, I n. What was this n? We have hash defined it as 100. So an array of size 100 has been declared. I tell the user enter the number of values. I scan it within n. Then I tell the user enter those %d values, which is the n which you have scanned a while back. Those many values one by one, user enters those, and that many times you scan those in AI, that is A0, A1, A2, A3 and so on you have scanned, and then you have printed the values of the array one by one. So you know the meaning of an array, how basic programs are written with an array. So you have just scanned those values and printed those values, this much. So if you have a look at an array looks like this. Say an array A, it looks like, say 2, 4, 7, 3, 1, 5 values in the array. So with what array it is? It is an array of integers. Similarly, it could have been 2.3, 4.9, 7.5, 3.8 and so on. That is an array of floating point numbers. So suppose this is an array A, 2, 4, 7, 3, 1. There is another array B. Say 7, 8, 6, 9, 2. Similarly, there is another array C, 4, 3, 9, 6, 1. Another array D, and so on. So A is an array, B is an array, C is an array, D is an array, and so on. Actually, what if I have an array of arrays? That is an array of arrays. Array of arrays means many arrays, but it's an array of array. Suppose I can call, say, this array as, say, what should I say, A0. Now, suppose I call this array, say A1, just an example, just to, this is A1. Suppose I call this, sorry, this array I call A2. Say this array I call A3, say 5, 8, 9, 2, 6, here also there is a 7, so these are all arrays A0, A1, A2, A3, as if they are different arrays. Now what I mean to say is, suppose now I declare an array of arrays. How to do that? Say if I declare an array called A100, it means it is an array of arrays. It is an array of 100 arrays, each array containing 100 numbers. Say, suppose I write int before this, it means that A0 is an array, A1 is an array, A2 is an array, A3 is an array. So there are 100 arrays like this, and each array contains 100 numbers maximum. So it is an array of arrays. Now what I mean to say over here is, if I declare something like this int A100, then A0 is an array, A1 is an array, A2 is an array, A3 is an array, and so on. That means if I declare something like this, I can access this 2 as A00. This 2 becomes A00. You can access this 2 as A00. This 4, maybe you can access as A01. You understand what I mean to say? A0 is the array. Check out. A0 is the array containing 24731. So A0, within A0 array, the 0th element is 2. Again, in the A0 array, the 1th element, the next element is 4. Like you used to access this as A0, A1, A2, A3 and so on, because A was the name of the array. Now A0 is the name of the array, as if. A00 is 2, A01 is 4. Similarly, this 7, what is this 7? This 7 is A02. Because in the A0, this is the A0 array, this is the A0 array, and in the A0 array, this second element is 7. Similarly, this 3 is A03. Please try to understand this. Similarly, this 1 is A04. I repeat once more. This is A0 array. Within A0 array, the fourth element is 1. And this array is A0. A0 is this array, A1 is this array. And the entire array has been declared int A100. What is this? An array of array. 100 arrays, each of size 100. 100 arrays, so this indicates A0 to A99, 100 arrays. And this 100, next 100 indicates that in each array from A0 to A99, in each array, there can be maximum 100 elements. So this does not mean that there has to be 100 arrays, and this does not mean there has to be 100 elements in each array. It means that there can be maximum 100 arrays, and in each array there can be maximum 100 elements, an array of arrays, which we call 2D array, two-dimensional array. Why two-dimensional array? Looks like a two-dimensional thing. See 2, 4, 7, 3, 1. This is one direction, and this is another direction. As if a 2D array looks like a matrix, is not so? 2, 4, 7, 3, 1 is the first row of the matrix. 7, 8, 6, 9, 2, as if the next row of the matrix. And so on. If you go for the next one, say 3, 9, 6, 1, 7, maybe 3, 9, 6, 1, 7 is another row of the matrix. Now, I will ask you one question now. What will you call this element? This element is an element of which array? This element 7 is an element of A1 array. A1 is the name of the array, like A was the name of the array when we are using 1D array. A was the name of the array, like that. A1 is the name of the array. So this 7 is basically A10, isn't it so? A10. This 8 is A11. What does it indicate? A1 is the array name. Out of that, the 1th element is 8. Similarly, you check out this 6. This is A12. A1 is the name of the array. Out of that, the 2th element is 6. Similarly, this is A13. This is A14. And so on. So, you can understand very easily that in the next array is A2. This 3 is A20, 9 is A21, this 6 is A22, this is A23, this is A24, and similarly, if this is the A3 array, then 5, 8, 9, 2, 6, 5 is A30, 8 is A31, 9 is A32, 2 is A33, and 6 is A34, and so on. You can write that yourself. I am not writing it. So I think you understand. This whole array can be treated as A100, where there can be maximum 100 arrays, and in each array there can be maximum 100 elements. Like over here, we have used 4 arrays, in each array there are 5 elements. So these figures can also vary. I have written A100 does not mean that it is a square matrix or something like that. No, nothing like that. There can be maximum 100 arrays. In each array, there can be maximum 100 elements. So, you may declare 10 arrays. In each array, you may declare maybe 20 elements. That is also possible. Like over here, I have used 4 arrays. In each array, I have used 5 elements. So, you declare it as int A100. Or maybe, n is hash defined as 100. You may declare an array as what? Int A, is not so? Int A(n). Now this element accessed as A11. This element accessed as A12. This element accessed as A13, and so on. So I believe you understand this. So maybe how will I write such an array program, or how will I maybe input this array elements from the user. Say from A00 to A04, if I want to print, I can say for I equal to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus, print A0i. Check out, A0 is the name of the array. So instead of writing AI, I can write A0i. For I equal to 0, this 0, check out, this 0, for I equal to 0, I less than 5, that is I less than equal to 4, I plus plus, print A0i, that is 00, 01, 02, 03, 04. Similarly, if I want to print the next array, you can print for I equal to 0, this 0, which 0, this 0. For I equal to 0, I less than 5, that is less than equal to 4, I plus plus, maybe print A1i, that is 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Similarly, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24 can be printed. 30, 31, 32, 33, 34 can be printed. In this way, you may print the array elements one by one. However, if you want to treat this as a single 2D array, as I was describing, it is an array of arrays. So, a single 2D array, a single array of arrays, you want to print all the elements. Maybe you call it row-wise, treat each array as a row. This is the row, this whole thing is as if a matrix, and this whole thing, this A0 is as if a row. This is the next row, isn't it so? This is the next row, and so on. So suppose you want to treat this as a 2D array or an entire matrix and want to print this array row wise, how can you do that? See, you need to print A0i from 0 to maybe 5 minus 1, that is 0 to 4. Similarly, you want to print A10 to 14. Similarly, you want to print A20 to 24. Then you want to print A30 to 34. That is, you also want to print AI0 to I4. So, another outer for loop will be needed. Is that so? So, let me write this program. How? Int ANN has been declared. I leave this one now. I don't know what will be needed. Let me see later. But int ANN is needed. An array of size n cross n. That is, n rows and n columns. You may think it in two different ways. You can think it like maximum n arrays. In each array, there are n elements maximum. I repeat, you can think it like this. N arrays maximum. In each array, maximum n elements. Or you may think of it as one single 2D arrays of n rows and n columns. See, is that so? You can think this one like four arrays. In each array, there are maximum 5 elements. Similarly, you can think of it as a 4 cross 5 array. Isn't it so? So, you can, what I am trying to mean over here is, int ANN, I can treat it like a 2D array of maximum size, of maximum n rows and n columns. However, the number of rows and columns may vary. However, now I print, say, enter the number of values. What should I say instead? I should say, enter the number of rows and columns. If I treat it as one 2D array or one matrix having maximum n rows and maximum n columns. So, enter the number of rows and columns. It is expected user will enter two figures then, one row and one column. And you have to scan two numbers then, percentage m, percent n, percent m and percent n. So, m contains number of rows, n contains number of columns. You can think like this. M contains number of rows. So, m is this, 4. 4 rows. 4 rows. M is this. Check out. M is this. Which one? This. 4 rows over here. And n, user will enter number of columns. So, this is the number of columns. How many? 5. So, I think you understand this. So, m and n I scan. Now, I will tell the user, enter the values of the matrix, I can say. I treat this as a matrix. I treat this 2D array as a matrix, values of the matrix row wise. I'm telling the user enter the values row wise. Row wise means enter the first row, then enter the second row, then enter the third row. Row wise means firstly I'm telling the user enter 2, then 4, then 7, then 3, then 1. Then you enter the next row, that is 7, 8, 6, 9, 2. Then you enter the next row, 3, 9, 6, 1, 7. Then you enter the next row, 5, 8, 9, 2, 6, and so on. So I'm telling the user enter the values of the matrix row wise. Now how do I need to scan? Say I only have to scan the A0 array. That is, you can treat it as the first A0 array, or you can treat it as the first row. If I have to scan the first row, then I need to scan A0i. Will you agree with me? Where I will vary from 0 to n, because n is the number of columns. N is the number of columns means n over here is 5. So n is the number of columns means how many elements are there in the row. There are 5 elements in the row. If I think of the A0 array, in the A0 array, how many elements are there? 5 elements are there. Why? How many columns are there? 5 columns are there. Where has the user entered the number of columns? Where have you scanned it? He has scanned it in n. So how many columns are there? N number of columns. So how many elements are there in the first row? N number of elements. I repeat, user has entered the number of columns in where? You have scanned it in n. How many columns? 5 columns. So how many elements are there in the first row? Definitely, because there are 5 columns, there are 5 elements in the first row. So where has the user entered the columns? In n. So how many elements in the first row? N elements. So for I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus, what are you scanning? You are scanning A0i. But you also need to scan A1i. So what will you do? Will you write again? Say like this. Will you write again? For I equal to 0, I am deliberately writing it to make you understand. For I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus, will you write scanf percent d ampersand a1i? See what happens then. I am scanning n elements of the second row. N is the number of columns, so number of elements in the second row, that is the 1th row, is also how many? 5. So again you are scanning A10, A11, A12, A13, A14, that is A1i. Similarly, will you scan A2i? Maybe I can copy paste this to make you understand. Will you write A2i? See this. So in the next for loop, will you write A2i? What I mean to say, I think you can understand what I mean to say. I am scanning A0i. I am scanning A1i. I am scanning A2i. I am scanning A3i. In this way, how many do I need to scan? I am scanning one row in each scan. I am scanning one row. A0i, A00, A01, A02, A03, and so on. So entire A0i I am scanning. I am scanning the 0th row. Then I am scanning the 1th row. Then I am scanning the 2th row. How many rows do I need to scan? I need to scan m rows. So instead of writing so many for loops, what will I write? I will write one entire outer for loop. I think you people have understood this till now, that you need to do another for loop where for you can write I equal to 0, I less than m, I plus plus. So here you are using I. So instead of using I over in the next inner for loop, let me do this with j. For j equal to 0, j less than n, j plus plus, I am scanning a 0, j, all the same. Instead of doing it with I, if I do it with j, what am I doing? I am scanning a 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3, up to 0, n minus 1. That is n minus 1 because n is the number of columns. Number of columns means that many elements in the row. So I have scanned A0, entire A0 array, or I have scanned the 0th row, that is from 00 to 0n minus 1 with the help of 0j. But I also need to scan A1 in the same way. I need to scan A2 in the same way, A3 in the same way, up to AM minus 1, that many arrays, because that many rows are there. M contains the number of rows. M contains the number of rows means this 1, 2, 3, 4. So that many arrays you need to scan. So I have varied I equal to 0 to I less than M, I plus plus. Why? Because I will replace this 0 with I. See what happens as a result. Firstly, you enter the outer for loop. You enter this outer for loop with the value of I equal to how much? 0. So here you enter with J equal to 0. You are scanning what? A00. You go back to the inner for loop and increment. This is not I plus plus, this is J plus plus, sorry. You increment J. So what happens? J becomes 1. What are you scanning? A01. Again you go back to the inner for loop, J becomes 2. What are you scanning? A02. Similarly over here, J becomes 3. What are you scanning? A03. And so on. In this way, suppose you have scanned also A04 and the value of N was given as 5. So there are 5 columns. 5 columns means 5 elements in the 0th row. So you have scanned from A00 to A04. J becomes 5, 5 less than 5 is false, it goes out of the inner for loop. So in the outer for loop it continues with I plus plus, I becomes 1. So this time it again enters with J equal to 0 but I is 1. So what are you scanning? A10. J becomes 1 again. What are you scanning? A11. J becomes 2. What are you scanning? A12. And so on. Similarly, you will scan up to A14, J becomes 5, 5 less than 5 is false, it will go out, go to the outer for loop again, I becomes 2. So what are you scanning? A20, A21, A22, A23, A24, and this becomes, it goes out of the loop because 5 less than 5 and I becomes 3. Similarly, 30, 31, 32, how long? As long as M. What is M? You have scanned M, number of rows. So how many times will this iterate? Number of rows. So the entire array will be scanned in this way. But user will enter one after the other. Enter the elements row wise one after the other. Is that so? So how will you print these values? Maybe row wise. The values of the array printed row wise. If you have to print it row wise, maybe you need to print the same thing. Suppose if I copy this and just replace the scanf by printf, what happens? Let me see once. Say I just print the values of the array printed row wise. I just get rid of this and I do the same thing. For I equal to 0, I less than m, I plus plus. I do for j equal to 0, j less than n, j plus plus. Scanf percent eij instead of scanf, I replace it by printf. That is, I print it row wise. Initially, I am printing A00. Then I am printing A01. Then I am printing A02. Then 03 and so on. Then I go out, I becomes 1. I am printing 10, 11, 12 and so on. So I am printing one after the other. Printf does not need this ampersand. So this printing, what will it print? You need to give a gap to see. I need to give a gap. Maybe two gaps I give. Now I say I go for it, I run this program and let's see what happens. I have needed I have needed N, also I needed J and I needed M. So I need to declare J and M. So I, J, M, N, this is what you needed. So now let me run this program after commenting out this section of code where I tried to explain you the meaning of a 2D array. So this much is left out. Now I run the program, let's see what happens. Alt R, enter. Enter the number of rows and columns. Say 3 rows and 4 columns. That is, you can say 3 rows. 3 rows means downwards you go 3 steps. And 4 columns, that is horizontally you go 4 steps. So 3 and 4. So let me now say enter the values of the matrix row wise. So in the first row I want 2, 9 and 8. In the first row I am entering, I am not printing. When I print I expect the values to be printed in a proper 2D way. Let's see whether that happens or not. enter the values of the matrix row wise. So there are 3 rows and 4 columns. So in the first row, how many numbers will be there? There are 3 rows and 4 columns. So if there are 4 columns, in each row, how many numbers are there? 4 numbers. I repeat, 3 rows and 4 columns. So downwards you go 3 steps, 3 rows. 4 columns, horizontally you move 4 steps. So how many numbers are there in each row? There are 4 numbers in each row. So in the first row, 298, another number should be there, maybe 1. Now I go to the second row. So in the second row, I want 5, 7, 3, 2. Now I go to the third row. There are 3 rows. Downwards I go 3. 3 rows. 1, 8, 4, 2. Let's see. Now it should be printed. 3 rows and 4 columns. See how it is printed. The values of the array printed row wise are 2, 9, 8, 1, 5, 7, 3, 2, 1, 8, 4, 2. Has it printed row wise? No. It has just printed all the values in one after the other. But I want to print it row wise to give it the filling of the matrix. See, for that what do I need to do? You remember over here, this inner for loop, what has it done? It has printed the 0th row first because I entered with 0. So the 0th row was printed first. Then it went here and then it printed the 1th row. So execution of the inner for loop once is printing one row. What if after the execution of the inner for loop, I go to a new line? See what? I am going to a new line. After the execution of the inner for loop, I am not going there after every printf %d. No. In that case, all numbers will be printed in different lines. I don't want that. This inner for loop has printed one row. So after printing one row, I go to a new line. Then the outer for loop takes I to the next row. So here in the inner for loop, I am printing the next row. So after printing the next row, what do? I go to the next line. So every row printed, I go to the next line. But that means the outer for loop now has got two lines. I need a bracket. If it would have contained one for loop, one block, doesn't matter at all. But here you need an extra printf. What have I done? Inner for loop has printed one row. After printing one row, I have gone to a new line. And then again gone to printing the next row. This is how I have done it. Let me run this program once more. Alt R, enter. Center the number of rows and columns. 3 and 4 again. So the first row, 1, 8, 7, 6. Second row, 4, 3, 2, 9. Third row, 4, 0, 7, 2. The values of the array printed row wise. See, first row, 0th row, 1, 8, 7, 6. 1th row, 4, 3, 2, 9. 2th row, 4, 0, 7, 2. We have printed the arrays row wise. While scanning, you also could have told the user, interestingly, you could have asked the values from the user row wise. How? After scanning every row, you could have told the user enter the values of the next row. Like over here, enter the values of the matrix row wise. Over here, what if I tell the user before scanning the first row, I am scanning the 0th row. Remember, I have entered I with 0 first time. I is 0, I enter over here. J becomes 0, 1, 2, 3. So I am scanning 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3. I am scanning the first 0th row. So before scanning the 0th row, I am telling the user printf enter the values in the %dth row. That is in which row? In the 0th row. What is that 0? Who contains that 0? I. See, I enters with 0. I am telling enter the values in the 0th row. But next time what will happen? When this entire scanning of 0th row is done, the inner for loop will be completely executed. When the inner for loop will be completely executed from 00 to 0n minus 1. Remember, from 00 to 0n minus 1, it will be executed. After executing, it will go over here and I will become 1. Then it will print enter the values in the 1th row. And so on. In this way, the printing can be done. Enter the values in the ith row, I am telling. Ith row means 0th row, 1th row and so on. What happens? Let me run this program and see once. Enter the number of rows and columns, 3 and 4 again, just to make it sure. Enter the values of the matrix row wise. It is saying first. Then it is saying enter the values in the 0th row. So you may enter it now. I forgot to give that slash n over here. After the 0th row, I should have given a slash n. Anyway, I can enter. I enter 5. Enter the values in the 0th row. 5. How many? 4. There are 3 rows and 4 columns. 4 columns means 4 numbers in each row. So 5, 7, 2, 9. See what it says. Enter the values in the 1th row. 4 numbers have been entered. So enter the values in the 1th row. You again print 6, 2, 3, 9. It will say enter the values in the 2th row. 9, 0, 5, 4. The values of the array printed row wise 5, 7, 2, 9, 6, 2, 3, 9, 9, 0, 5, 4. I should have given a slash n after saying this person dth row. Over here, I need a slash n. I forgot this. So a slash n must be printed. Also, another thing I could have done, enter. Why? You have understood why this is I. Because I is entering with the row number. 0 is the 0th row. When I is 0, you are scanning A, I 0, I 1, I 2 and so on. That is 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2 and so on. So I is 0. Similarly, when I is 1, you are scanning 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2 and so on. So this I is the row number. So that's why I. Now you can say enter the person D values in the person Dth row. What is that person D values? How many values are there in each row? Tell me, in each row, how many values are there? Number of columns. In our example, we were entering 3, 4. So the number of columns, we are saying 4. Columns 4 means how many elements in each row? 4 elements in each row. So how many elements will be in each row? That is, n number of values in each row. That is why I am scanning from j equal to 0 to j less than n, j plus plus. Let me run this program once. Alt R, enter. Enter the number of rows and columns 3 and 4 again. Enter the values of the matrix rows y. Enter the 0. There is some problem. Anyway, 3, 4, why this has become 0? We will check out, inspect again. 6, 5. Then enter the 1 values in the 4th row. I have done some mistake. I have just swapped it. This 4 should have been first, then the 1. I think you understand. This has become 4th row, not 4th row. It should have become 0th row, 1th row. I have just exchanged the I and N. That's the mistake I did. Anyway, 5, 8, 9, 2. Then again, 7, 6, 4, 3. So these are the values printed row wise. What mistake I did? See, person D values in the person Dth row. Person D values, this is N. The first person D is N. And then row number, that is I. Person dth row, this is the ith row. However, n is the number of values in each row. So this n should replace the number of values. And I should replace the row number. I just did the reverse. I did it wrongly. Anyway, run it again. Alt R, enter. Enter the number of rows and columns 3 and 4 again. Enter the values of the matrix row wise. So enter the 4 values in the 0th row. See, enter the 4 values in the 0th row. 5, 6, 7, 8. 4 values in the 0th row. Enter the 4 values in the 1th row. 1, 2, 3, 4. Enter the 4 values in the 2th row. 8, 6, 4, 2. The values of the array printed row wise. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, 6, 4, 2. You can do it easily. It gives you the form of a matrix. I think you understand this. I will request all of you. This I will keep absolutely intact. I will keep this absolutely intact and go out. You take a break. When I come back, this program will remain as it is. And I will do all modifications on the program. What modifications will I do? I will print the sum of each row also. On the right side of printing each row at the end, I will print the sum of each row. And after printing the entire array, I will print the sum of each column also. So think of that yourself. Also see this program time and again. Write this program yourself. We can take a bit of break and come back. Thank you.